Thanks for taking time away to come and talk to us and our audience here. We are the ABC station here in Northwest Arkansas, and I'm sure everyone's excited to hear from you. So, sure, I would love to start by getting both of your perspective on Arkansas. We'll start with you. You've never been here before.
I haven't.
And what do you think so far in the short time you've been here?
Well, I immediately bonded with Bentonville because I got off the plane at Fayetteville. And we drove to Bentonville and got to the Bentonville Town Square, and I thought, it's like the Town Square from Back to the Future, the 1950s one. And it's got like that fantastic building at one end, and then it's got these wonderful like restaurants with the sort of white and red and blue 50s like awnings coming out, and I was because that's Back to the Future is my favorite film.
Oh, okay.
So. To have the square be so representative of that, because coming from England, I don't know what that kind of midtown, you know, small to midtown mm-hmm. America looks like, and it's to me it's just so idealistic, you know.
Yeah.
So we were just sort of strolling around last night. I was just sort of walking, feeling like I was in so many of these sort of Americana films that I loved growing up. It just felt a bit like that to me, which is which was good. It's kind of magic to me.
I did know that I've always been a huge fan of like southern food, and so I know I wanted to try fried chicken and grits down, and I've accomplished both, and I've only been here about less than 24 hours, and I've already accomplished both.
Did you go to Table Mesa or one of the restaurants?
No, we went to the Tuscan Trotter.
Oh yeah, mm-hmm.
Which was delicious.
Excellent. So you were walking around the square. Did you have a chance to talk to anybody? I mean, what was that like for the two of you last night?
Did we have a chance to talk to people?
Yeah, we went into that fantastic pop-up gallery that was happening.
Yeah. Y'all have a pop-up gallery that's opening. That's really.
You said y'all, like a southerner.
You've already acclimated.
That was
just
cool.
Stay now.
Well, I grew up in Indiana, and this really reminds me of where I grew up.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. So this is the town I grew up in when I was little. Was actually smaller than Bentonville, but yeah, really like the weather, the trees, the architecture, the people. So it just like I a bit feel like I'm back home.
So it's all right. This is the last question I'll ask about Arkansas. But do you think now, having been here, that you could play a southern character in a film if there was ever a film shot here? Could you give us a convincing y'all?
Well, y'all asked the right question, because if it segues beautifully into our movie. My character in the movie is actually from West Virginia.
Okay.
So, I just did it. Is the answer.
Well, let's talk a little bit about that film. Obviously, that's why both of you are here. It's part of this film festival, which is centered on women and diversity. Mm-hmm. Why do you think that this was an appropriate film to be showcased in this festival? What makes it centered around that, other than obviously having you play a key role in it?
Well, I think that's, yeah, it was, I wrote it, so it's written by women, directed by women, it's produced by women, which wasn't really by design. I mean, it was just sort of organically how that happened. So I feel like having those key roles be populated by women makes it, mm-hmm. I guess, a unique film and makes it, appropriate to be in the festival, which we're very proud to be part of. I think this is a very important festival.
Okay, last question for both of you. Just your thoughts generally on the Bentonville Film Festival and its core mission of promoting more women and diversity in the entertainment industry. We could start with you.
Well, yeah, I mean, I think it's a great, I think obviously every festival which flourishes has its kind of core system of, its modus operandi. It's kind of like, it's own sort of personality, its stamp, and I think it's as valid a stamp as any. Particularly, we were talking to some of the people involved in putting on the festival, and they were saying that not only do they want it to be about women and diversity, but also about showcasing films that hopefully will get distributed and get seen. Mm-hmm. And I think that's really important, because sometimes you flick through these festival programs and you look at 150 films, all of which the writer has spent 2 years nourishing, and then the directors have worked on for you know, a year and a half, you know, before you even get to shooting and pitch, just slating it all out in their head, and then the actors come in, and then you have the post-production, you know, and all this soul has gone into making these films. And the sad truth of it is that three quarters of them, more probably, will, if you look at the statistics from festivals, won't get seen. Whereas I think the idea of trying to have a festival which not only celebrates women and diversity but also gets those films out into the public eye is really the important thing. Because if we're only making films, you know, that represent women and diversity, but only the people who are working at a festival are going to see them, or in the particular town that the festival's being shown are going to see them, then it's a slightly fruitless exercise, I think. So I think that's sort of one of the important things. And, you know, as someone who's worked exclusively with female directors in the last year, which is a very sort of underrepresented faction, I think, you know, I think it's you know, it's kind of important to sort of boost and support that participation.
That's a great point about the festivals. Any thoughts from you too?
Yeah, I mean, I'm exactly what he said. No, I think that it's lovely when that's the criteria. I think that it be about women and diversity, then that allows for movies that are artistically unique, allows for movies that are a very particular vision, and also allows for movies that are commercially viable. Mm-hmm. And I think that because there are movies that are championing either women in terms of their topic or in terms of the filmmakers, the commercial viability aspect is really important, mm-hmm. because then it means that we're championing movies that have a chance to reach as many people and as many women and girls as we possibly can.
Yeah.
So I think it's a fantastic premise for a festival. I'm very proud to be here, very proud to be a part of it.
We're glad you're here too. Where can people who are watching this right now, who might miss the screening today, where would they be able to see the film?
The film is going to be released in July. It's going to be released in some theaters across the country, and then also it will be available for online viewing.
Excellent.
Yeah.
All right, so stay tuned. Thanks so much, guys.